Aquarius, it's me, Stormy, and here is your horoscope for October 2018. And Aquarius, before we jump on in here, the 2018 holiday gift is up. Just click in the description box down below. You can take advantage of that gift for the holiday season. And I believe that the only appointments left now are the ones in January. So if there is a spot that you would like, click down below and take advantage, okay? All right, Aquarius. So this month, actually kind of interesting. A couple things. First of all, the big ticket item is that Venus is going to be going retrograde, kicking off at the beginning of the month, going all the way until November. Now, I hope you watched my Venus retrograde video. If you haven't, make sure you check it out. It's the very first one in the October playlist, so check that out, okay? But basically, when Venus is going retrograde, first of all, a retrograde pulls us back. We're going back. We're reviewing, reevaluating, re-editing, rethinking, reconnecting. There's a reunion sometimes of things that happen, right? So when it's Venus, though, this can be about romance. This can be about finance. But the big thing that I really think about when I think about Venus is value. What is the value of something? Now, it is highly recommended that during a Venus retrograde, you don't make any really big, huge purchases if you can avoid that or do any cosmetic surgery. But one of the things that I find is that really, truly, during a Venus retrograde, maybe if you have something to sell, you might get a pretty penny for it. So think about if there are things that you need to shed and you need to let go of. Uranus is down there in your fourth house. It's shaking things around. What needs to leave your house? What needs to leave your belief structure? It has no value anymore, so shake it off, okay? Like, be like Taylor Swift, shake it off, okay? Now, as we're looking at this Venus retrograde, it can definitely bring back past relationships. So you need to be mindful of that. Now, whatever is coming back from the past, whether it be the actual person, a relationship, just the thought of it, maybe even an opportunity in business or something like that, because it is at the top of your chart, these things are coming back for you to, first of all, observe and evaluate, and then later, as we get into November, take action on. It's about healing and clearing out. That's why we have a retrograde, to go back to something, see what's there, sift through the minutiae of all of it, and get rid of what is no longer salvageable or has value in your life, okay? Now, Venus being retrograde in the sign of Scorpio is at the tip top of your chart, so up here in the 10th house space. So the very first thing I keep thinking of, Aquarius, is your self-esteem when it comes to your career or being out in the world. The 10th house is the house of career, our reputation, things we're doing out in the world socially. I like to call it your soul level calling house, because it's the place where even if you are retired or unemployed, these are the gifts you have that you take out and you give to the world to help make it better. It's how you use your resources in the world or help somebody use theirs. So I think of this retrograde as really tapping into your self-esteem around the workplace, right? You guys have just had a run of it for a while in both love and business, okay? So this could definitely be something where, you know, when Venus is retrograde, sometimes your esteem can really, like, it can take a hit, like your mojo just got sucked out because your magnetism is gone. But really with this one, I'm also wondering if it's not putting you in a position to reevaluate your esteem and your value where you're working, or maybe in a project that you're doing, or asking the value of the work that you're doing in general. Are you making the money you need to make? And you'll only know that if you honestly sit down and look at your budget. You will only know that if you honestly know the skills that you're bringing to the table to demand more money, right? Whether that be you're an entrepreneur, you work on your own, or you work for a company, or you're retired and you're out and you want to demand value from something. But whatever it is, you're reevaluating value opportunities at the top of your chart, okay? Now, I also think that this is very, very interesting because Venus in the 10th house really does like love. Love with coworkers, love with something that you loved, love with somebody you were maybe in love with that you worked. And again, you've got Uranus down here in the fourth house. So these two houses sit opposite for you in the chart this month. You could be having some things going on at home as well. Is something happening with a family member and that's shaking up in the bottom of your chart and it's causing some shift. It's causing you to reevaluate something up in your career life or vice versa, okay? Now, that is all happening on the 5th of October, and will go until November 16th, okay? Now, on the 8th, we've got a new moon happening in the sign of Libra. So at the new moon, we plant these seeds of intention for what we'd like to create going forward. We plant those seeds of intention in the dark. We don't know what they're going to look like when they blossom. We hope if we planted pumpkins, we're going to get pumpkins, but you never know what kind of pumpkin you're going to actually get, right? Even though it's orange on the package, it could come out white. So you don't know, but you plant it with the hope in the belief that if you take a little bit of action, you water it, you give it enough sunlight, and then you leave it alone, the universe is going to help that energy bring it to you. You're going to manifest in that way. Now, in the sign of Libra, first of all, this rocks your ninth house space. And first and foremost, this is the space of faith. This is new faith, new belief, new trust, because faith has very little to do with what is coming out of your mouth. Right? It has very little to do with what you believe. Faith has everything to do with your actions. How are you acting? Are you acting like the universe has got your back? Are you unemployed and terrified, but you are out there believing that the universe has got your back by applying, asking for people for help? In the ninth house space, this is also higher thought, higher education, higher mind, foreign travel, right? We're not talking about you take a trip from one city to the next. We jump an ocean, right? We're going to get into foreign territories instead of just domestic space. So for you, with Libra here, you could have new relations or relationships coming into your life from any one of these spaces, whether it be a mentor coming into your relationship. You finally decide to sign on with that university. You're going for that certification, that licensing. You know what I mean? Maybe you got that new job. Something came back to the table. You forgot about it. You applied for that 100 years ago, right? Or you started that project 100 years ago and you didn't see the value of it. And now with this new moon and over the next 4 to 6 weeks, you're watching it start to pan out. You're getting the trainings you need. You're getting the education you need. Oh my goodness, did that past relationship come back and now is the right time, right? But that person happens to live in another country. Oh, okay, let's see how we're going to work that out. So it's endless possibilities, but what's going to happen at this new moon is you're going to have a start here in this ninth house space, and whatever your brand new start is, Aquarius, you are going to have a lot of faith in whatever you think is bigger than you, whatever it is that you appeal to, that you're going to be able to do it, right? You're going to jump off that cliff and either be given wings to fly or the ground is going to be right there and you'll still be walking, right? So a lot of faith is going to develop here. Now, being in the sign of Libra, which is those relationships, one of the first relationships I think you're going to have to evaluate, or maybe even just in general you'll have to evaluate, is where your balance is at. Libra likes to balance those scales. So where in your relationship, where in your education, where in your faith, where in whatever it is that you're doing, where are you out of balance? And you've got to find your equilibrium. You've got to bring balance there. Now, balance always starts with inner harmony, right? So you may have to look around in here a little bit. And that's fine. It's a new moon. Do it. On the 10th of the month, we've got Mercury coming into Scorpio. Scorpio is a very big, very busy place this month. Very busy. So your career house is going to be rocking, because right now in the 10th house, what we've got up there is Jupiter, our biggest benefic planet. So he's bringing wisdom to the table. He's also bringing opportunity. And the nice thing about Jupiter is he's not highly emotional. He's like, look, I'm going to shine up here and be bright and bring you stuff. I need you to do something with it, right? Like, he's pretty unemotional about the business. Then we've got Venus, who's our smaller benefic planet. You've got both of the benefic planets up there, even if Venus is retrograde. Now you've got Mercury up there as well in Scorpio in the 10th house, and Mercury makes you a phenomenal observer. You become an amazing observer of what's going on, because Mercury is very mentally savvy. It's picking up the patterns. It's picking up the strategy. It's communicating, right? Maybe at work, it's time for you to be communicating in a different way, maybe in a way that's a little bit more efficient or something like that, right? But whatever it is, Mercury in Scorpio really does make your conversation a little bit more efficient as well, because you're working from the root of the issue or the root of the challenge or the root of the truth instead of all of the kind of minutiae around it. Now, I will tell you too, I do think this for some of you. You may be making decisions around work based off of something that's happening at home. Maybe it's time to move and you're relocating and taking that new job or whatever it is. There is very much so this aspect connected to your ruling planet of Uranus down in the fourth house that is shaking you up here in the 10th house. And it's wise. You're trying to work here and make good decisions. You're clearing a path to success for you. I am sure, Aquarius, there's a couple of you out there I know have got some big plans in the making. I know that you do, and some of them do include romance, not just business. So you're clearing the way here. Mercury is very business savvy. He's very savvy in general. So this will be your mind on fleek, ready to communicate and help you move forward. Now on the 23rd, we have the sun also moving up there into the Scorpio energy. So again in the 10th house, but when the sun comes here, it brings light, heat, life, vitality, movement. You want to be seen here. You want to be known here. You want health here. This is how I know you're working actively on making this dream, this life thing come true, this business thing, even if it's just getting a new job or having the courage to leave the one that you're at. If you're retired, it's finding this purpose. Right? Have you been retired and you're kind of going crazy, or you've been retired and you're just enjoying the heck out of it, but there's this little nugget down there going, what else? What's next? Let's go see. Let's follow it. Let's find out. But your career path, your purpose path is going to be shifting just a little bit, but it's in a good way. All right, on the 24th, we've got a full moon happening in Taurus. Now, the very first question I ask with a full moon being in an earth sign is, where do you need to ground? Now, this is in your fourth house space. So where do you need to ground, or where are you looking for ground? A full moon says that something has to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. So we're going to have a shift here, right? In the fourth house, you could be moving your actual home base, right? Like you could be moving your foundation, your grounding. Like I said, maybe you're moving for work. Maybe you're just moving because it's time to move. Maybe you're moving because whatever reason you're moving. The fourth house can also be, the fourth house is home, family, property, real estate, foundations, inner security. If you've been working on your esteem in that outside world, you know, maybe you're starting to feel a little bit more at home in your inner world. This is your first home. If you've been working on it here, maybe it's starting to manifest in your outer world. I do get a sense too, though, that somebody could be moving in or out of your home, or this has a very family member vibe to it. So something could be going on with a family member that does impact your work this month, okay? Now, on the 26th, the Sun and Venus are going to be in conjunction up there in Scorpio, so you've got a change to your social life coming, okay? But you've been doing all of this work in your 10th house space to have self-transformation, right? You're doing some shifting there, so it would make sense that new people, new social groups, new opportunities are rolling into your life. Now, on the 31st, we've got a couple movements happening. First of all, Venus is going to take her retrograde on the road, so she's going to move from Scorpio back up into Libra. Now you're going to start to reevaluate this 9th house space. This is the house of faith. This is the house of higher education, foreign things. I lost my mind for a minute. Foreign things. So whether it's a foreign language, foreign country, foreign business, international business, things like that, or just people who are brand new to you, mentorship, teaching, religion, right? All of these things come here. So definitely school as well. Now, also on the 31st, Mercury is going to enter into the sign of Sagittarius. Now, I really, really like this for you because Mercury in Sagittarius gets very open-minded. And this month, you're having to come to a new perspective on things. You're having to welcome new people, places, and things into your life, right? So Mercury here in Sagittarius is giving new savvy conversation, new decision-making, new perspective to your social groups. So whether this is new friends, new organizations you align with, new groups, new humanitarian groups, new ideas for things that are social, whether it be social media or social programs out in the world, whatever it is, you get real open-minded about this. You're real tolerant. It's a very tolerant energy. And the other thing about it is that I think it gives you a nice level of confidence to move forward in this social scene. So I think it's going to be a really interesting month for you. I look forward to seeing how it unfolds. I mean, Aquarius, you've been working on some big plans. I know you have, some of you. And so it's going to be time now this month where it's not going to fully roll out this month, but I think the wheels do get to turn a little bit. You get to evaluate a couple things and see what you maybe need to adjust to continue to roll that. Get it going downhill, right? Get it going in some good speed. So I love you guys so much. Please like this video, comment, share, subscribe, and I will see you beautiful friends next month. Bye.